I'm Cal Kellogg, and my hybrid lead core system has brought lead core trolling back into the spotlight for trout and salmon anglers all over the country. If you'd like the world's best lead core trolling rod, get on over to fishhuntshoot.com and pick up one of my iconic bright yellow lead core rods today. You won't regret it, because you'll be yelling, "Fish on!" tomorrow. Wes Ward hooked up at Collins Lake. It's starting to turn on here, guys. On that rod, we're running the mag lip. That was down probably right at 15. Over here, we got a Trigger Junior right on the surface, and off the downrigger over here, we've got one of my trolling flies. So we're gonna see Wes's netting. Oh, nice trout, look at that. We're gonna see him net this fish while he's fighting it. And that was on our lead core. Awesome. The more we run mag lips, I keep saying it, the more impressed we are with them. We just keep on catching fish on mag lips. I think it's superior to a Rapala. Look at that fat rainbow. Wow.
Wow. Good fish.
2+ pounds. Look at the square tail on that fish. See, that's a holdover from this spring, maybe a pen trout. That is just a handsome trout. We're gonna get that guy back in the water as quick as we can. Hey guys, Cal Kellogg here. I got a question about line from an angler named John. He wrote this in response to one of my recent videos here on YouTube, and he asked, you know, what is the relationship between the strength of your main line and your leader? And I think what he was really driving at is, do I match the strength of my leader to the strength of my main line? And the answer to that question is no. I think there's three really important things about your leader. One is the strength of the leader you're using. Second is the diameter. And third is, what is it constructed out of, okay? So let's start off talking about my lead core rods. My lead core rods, I have a top shot that comes off the end of the lead core. That's always 17 or 20 pound fluorocarbon line, okay? I bring that down to a trolling swivel, and off that swivel, I'll run a leader that's either 8 or 10 pound test in most cases. If we're talking about my top lining rods or my downrigger rods, that is typically a rod that's spooled up with 10 pound test, either P-Line CXX in moss green or Trilene big game line, again in moss green. I bring that down to a trolling swivel, the same thing I use on the lead core, and from the trolling swivel, I run an 8 or 10 pound test leader. So I don't match the size of the leader to the size of the main line or the strength of the main line. I always make sure that I'm using a thin diameter fluorocarbon line in 8 or 10 pound test. Fluorocarbon reflects light at the same rate as water, basically. And that renders it virtually invisible to trout and other game fish. And that's not necessary every day, but you never know when it's necessary. So I always run with a fluorocarbon leader. The thing you gotta remember is to adjust your drag in reference to the breaking strength of your leader, okay? So even though I'm running maybe a 20 pound top shot on my lead core, I've got to have that drag adjusted to accommodate the fact that I'm using an 8 pound test leader. I like to run light drags. I'd rather err on the side of being too light rather than too heavy on the drag. So that's just something that I do. And I don't see any reason to drop down much below 8 pound test. I'm trying to set the stage for success. I'm always hoping to hook a larger than average fish. And the last thing I want to do is hook into a 10 or 12 pound rainbow with a 4 pound test leader. I don't think with the advent of, you know, fluorocarbon line that the fish can't see, I don't think you need to go down that fine. Now, back in the days when we just had regular old, you know, monofilament, that old strand, yes, sometimes you had to go down to 4 pound test to get hit. That's not the case anymore with fluorocarbon. That's just been a boon for anglers that fish in, you know, clear water for finicky fish. It just allows you to use heavier line than you could use in the past, and that means you're gonna land more of the big fish that you hook. Anyway, I hope that clears things up. John, I hope that clears things up for all the people out there that listen to this content on the Fish Hunt Shoot Productions channel. I want to thank you guys all for tuning in. If you haven't hit that subscribe button, please do. You'll always know when I'm on here talking about trout fishing tactics or whatever I'm talking about. And if you're looking for trout gear, go on over and check out my store at fishhuntshoot.com. You'll see my full line of reels, rods, trigger spoons, trolling flies, grubs, and more. The gear that you see me using here on the channel, the stuff you see me catching fish on, we offer up great gear at a very fair price, and I think this stuff's awesome, and I think you'll find it awesome too. I'm Kel Kellogg. I'm signing off for now. You stay healthy, happy, always wear your life jacket, and I will catch you next time right here on YouTube, guys. Have a great day.